Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Sedna Inuit, a powerful sea goddess who ruled over sea mammals, lesser spirits, and monsters, sometimes called Sea Woman. Among different groups in Alaska, Canada, and Greenland, Sedna was also known as Nulajuk, Nulayak, Kanakapfalik, Avalayok, Amapukua, Mother of the Sea, Takanakapsalik or Takanalik Arnalik, the Terrible One Down Under, and Unigamaswitok, the one who does not want a husband. She was considered to be the mother of both land and sea creatures and was therefore the provider of all life. The Inuit credited Sedna with the power to create storms, control the migration of animals, and hold back the supply of fish and game as punishment when people failed to honor the animals properly. Sedna also had responsibility for Adlivan, the underworld. Tales about Sedna's beginnings differ. In one legend, as a young girl, Sedna developed an uncontrollable appetite for flesh and tried to eat her own parents. They put her in an umiak, an open, hide-covered boat, took her out to sea, and pushed her overboard. When Sedna clung to the side of the boat, her parents cut off her fingers, joint by joint. The pieces of her fingers fell into the ocean and were transformed into fish, seals, whales, and all other sea animals. Sedna sank into the water with them and became their keeper. In the Netsilik Inuit version of the tale, Nulajuk, Sedna, was an orphan bullied by the other children. One day, while the people were moving to new hunting grounds on kayaks lashed together to form rafts, the children pushed Nulajuk overboard. When she tried to climb back into the raft, her tormentors cut off her fingers and watched as she sank into the water. In other versions of the story, Sedna was a beautiful young woman with many suitors, all of whom she refused. In one tale, she was tricked into marriage with a stormy petrel, a seabird, in the shape of a man. He took her far from her home, mistreated her, and made her miserable. In another story, she married a dog who had transformed himself into a man. In both of these tales, Sedna's father killed her husband. Father and daughter then set sail for home. In the first tale, their boat was attacked by a flock of birds attempting to avenge the death of Sedna's husband. In the second tale, a great storm arose. To appease the birds or calm the storm, Sedna's father threw her into the sea. To keep her from climbing back into the boat, he cut off her fingers. All these tales end the same way, with Sedna's fingers severed and transformed into sea creatures.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.